you have to be, you know, ahimsa and himsa. Himsa starts on yourself. How are we doing himsa? Violent. How are we becoming violent to ourselves? Anybody? How are we become violent to our own self?
Forgiveness.
Huh?
Forgiveness.
Yes, forgiveness. We do not forgive others, but how are we becoming non-violent to ourselves? Now, not following the principles of Jainism, of God. We can say, we're not following the Ten Commandments, we're not following the principles of God. When we do not follow these principles of God, what do? We become violent to ourselves because we become untruthful, we lie. That's again hurting our own self. Okay, we have ego problem. That's again hurting our own self because when you have ego problem, your mind is always disturbed. Right? And then you are not truthful. When you're not truthful, again you have that problem, right? So, and then alcoholism, drinking alcohol, again, it's hurting your own self. And so all those aspects, first of all, then having jealousy, anger, greed, all that is coming to your own self, right? Because it all builds up that negativity inside you, and you are, whatever you project, whatever is in your mind, that's what you project. From the face, you know, we have people who do face with you. And that's how they read the face. So, that is how to your own self first. So first of all, we have to cleanse our own self. Through yoga, through meditation, and through godliness, through the ten fingers. Remember the ten fingers, the ten commandments. Okay, so first you cleanse your own self. Then, number two, others. Now, non-violence, ahimsa towards others. Is it just killing and beating others, and is that non-violence? Is that violence? Anybody, is that only violence? What else besides this is violence? Besides this, the main violence is, you know what? To others, jealousy. Again, they're jealous of others. We get angry on others. Anybody does a little bit mistake, we found on that person like a lion. Why did you do this? And why this? And why that? All the whys. That's what we do to others. You don't realize God is in everyone's heart. How much are you hurting that person whom you're shouting at? Maybe then there's nothing in your mind later on. But that person is taking it in. How much that person is suffering inside just by you using your harsh words. So it's not just beating a person or killing an animal or all that. It's not ahimsa. Correct me if I'm wrong. Ahimsa is also hurting other people. Hurting other people's in mind, in thought, or in deed. Even by mind, you think of somebody very viciously, that's also ahimsa. Right? Ahimsa. That's also ahimsa. That's not following ahimsa, sorry. That's not following ahimsa. So all that, to the second, first of all, to yourself, number one, to somebody else, another person, and then, when you have developed, because, to be very honest, to turn people into straight away, because Africa is a total meeting country, right? And it's very difficult to tell somebody, okay, you're not going to kill animals, you have to be vegetarian. They say, why? What? And then you say, okay, because the animals are all part and parcel of God. But then, unless and until you don't change the person's conscience, then you will never reach the level of ahimsa, which is the root of Jainism. So, you have to first start within yourself. When you teach others through meditation, we teach, there's so many here, my colleague is here, she's going to give a little bit of enlightenment, Joanne. And there's so many children. What do? We do super brain yoga with them. We do meditation, a lot of meditation. And one of the meditations is of Jainism, to concentrate on the Murti of one of the Tirthankas. Yes. And, of course, and we also trying to teach them, and gradually non-violence to becoming a vegetarian, not killing animals, not eating animals, automatically comes. After the first stage and the second stage, the third stage automatically develops. And of course, we do tell them then that of course you should not kill animals, because animals are not meant for us. And so in a nutshell, sorry for the time, I just want, but my colleague here, Joanne, she's also a teacher at the school, and she'll just enlighten you a little bit on Jainism, and just about 3 minutes. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. If you have any questions, you can ask me later. Thanks.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Joanne, in Jalaram Academy International School. I teach a number of children from different countries. Actually, Hindus, Christians, we have Chinese in the school, we have the Jains, so we have the Sikhs, and I teach all those religions. So, basically what we teach in religion is about how, okay, maybe how to put this down, my voice is big enough. Mm-hmm. What I teach mostly in religion is an incorporated religion, in that there's no way that I'll teach physical, I mean, mainly Christianity, and then again teach Hinduism or so. I put these kids together in the same classroom. Actually, most of them, at the end of Form 4, that is all levels, they are able to take at least 2 religions. So mostly what we teach is about philosophy of religion, incorporated with things like actually the current facts that are happening in the world that we're living in. So we realize that it's not a matter of doctrines, but it's a matter of the kind of beliefs and practices, and apart from that, the life to live as a religious person. So it's not a matter of changing the perspective view of any type of religion. So today I'm gonna talk about the philosophy of Jainism, which she's talked much about in Ahimsa. And as we know that Jainism is the same, almost the same as Hinduism and Buddhism. So we realize that some of the ideas found in Hinduism and Buddhism are incorporated in Jainism. So how do we put this to the children that we stay with? You know, all our, like the life we have today, the kind of children I deal with in school are just not normal children. These are rich children from rich families. And dealing with them is not very easy. So there are times that our lessons are based on characteristics of behavior. Our lessons are also based on contemporary issues, like things to do with abortion, things moms and dads don't want to talk about. Things like euthanasia, which many people don't want to talk about. These are the things we incorporate in the lesson. And these all are about violence that happened today. The world is full of sin. Is that true? So the world is full of sin. And for this reason, my religion classes are incorporated with the matters of today. So some of these things are moral values that some of our parents really don't like to mention. But I got the opportunity to have these kids with me, and I actually mentioned them without calling a spoon. I mean, I call the spoon a spoon, not a big spoon, or a spade a spade. The reason is because if these things are not taught to the youth in the classrooms, then we realize that because the parents are fearing from saying these things, then they end up going the wrong way, especially the fact that most of our kids go out of the university. Most of their universities are out of the country. So we realize that when they're out there, their life is not the same as when they're around.